children, welcome back to all of you. Today onwards, we are going to start our periodic two syllabus and we will begin with the poem. The title of the poem is A Teacher for All Seasons and poetess Joanna Fuchs. In this poem, the poet expresses gratitude to a teacher for being a truly perfect person who is suitable for all the seasons. The poet compares teacher to the four seasons, showing us how the teacher contributes to the complete development of her students. Let us begin with the poem. A teacher is like spring, who nurtures new green sprouts, encourages and leads them whenever they have doubts. Now we know that spring is the season that announces the birth of new plants, and teacher is like spring season because she offers these new sprouts. Who are the new sprouts and the new plants? The little children. She is providing her protection against the elements of the evil. She nurtures them tenderly and guides them to the right path. Second stanza says, a teacher is like summer whose sunny temperament makes studying a pleasure, preventing discontent. During summer, the sun is warm and bright. It gives warmth and light and life to all. In the same way, teacher is always there, and she is compared to the summer season because she enlightens us. And she is a good temper teacher. The word is used, sunny temperament. She is good temper teacher, and her cheerful behavior ensures that studying is fun. Third stanza says, a teacher is like fall with methods crisp and clear, lessons of bright colors and a happy atmosphere. During the fall or the autumn season, fruits mature and leaves are bright in colors. They are red and brown in color, and the nature appears like a beauty. It is a time when every fruit reaches ripeness. And in the same stanza, the teacher is compared to the fall season because her methods of teaching are quick and effective. She is teaching lessons of bright colors, and she is creating a happy atmosphere around her or him, and she is preventing any kind of dissatisfaction among the children. Fourth stanza says, a teacher is like winter while it's snowing hard outside, keeping students comfortable as a warm and helpful guide. All of us know that in the winter, the atmosphere outside is dull and frozen, and the teacher is keeping her students comfortable and warm because she is a helpful guide. The last stanza says, teacher, you do all these things with a pleasant attitude. You are a teacher for all seasons and you have my gratitude. In the last stanza, the poet is expressing gratitude to the teacher because she is the one who is doing all the things and having a pleasant attitude, and you are the teacher for all the seasons. So I'm thankful to you. Thank you. Words in the poem that have been explained here. For example, nurture means the act of nourishing or tender care, and the sprouts, a new growth on a plant or a child. Here, the new sprouts are the little children. In the next paragraph, there are two words. Encourage means to motivate or to give support. Temperament is a person's usual manner of thinking, behaving, or reacting. How a person reacts, how a person thinks, and how a person behaves. That is why it is said a teacher is having a sunny temperament, just like sun is shining all the day. So teacher is there to enlighten the students. In the fall season, the vocabulary is crisp and clear, quick and effective methods. Teaching methods of the teacher are very quick and effective. And the teacher is creating happy atmosphere, like the fall is having bright colors. So she is also creating an atmosphere of bright colors. Then is attitude, way of caring oneself or state of mind, how a person is caring and what is the state of mind of any person. And gratitude is the state of being grateful, mean giving thanks to someone. Write all these words in your notebook and learn them, and recite the poem also.